Hello friends, I'm back with another version of eBay Breaks. Got a lot of mail here. It's piled up on me since the holidays, and I've got behind. And a friend of mine told me a few days ago, Matthew, you haven't done a video in a while on YouTube, and I realized I hadn't. So 2 days ago, I did actually one video on a recent pickup, a Cubs lot that I got in a Facebook group. And now I'm going to try to go through some of this mail here and do a quick video. Share some recent pickups I've had with you. All of these, except for one, are well under a dollar pickups that I'm very pleased with, and bargains, which I'm always looking for. This first one here is a nice little lot that I picked up for my niece, Daisy, who is the basketball player in the family. She's been playing basketball for the last 3 years now, running, starting with Bitty Basketball a few years ago, and these cards are all three identical duplicates of the same card. What they are the 95-96 Team USA women's team. And while this wasn't an Olympic year, this right here is the same. This team right here traveled across the world nationally playing against the best women's teams, basketball teams in other countries during the 95-96 season. And I think that that's a great pickup to be able to get those cards right there from my niece. And I paid 7 cents free shipping for this lot. That's all three cards combined. 7 cents free shipping. You can't beat that. And Daisy, you know, loving basketball and playing basketball the way she does. And the fact that that's women's basketball, you know, national basketball team from 95-96. Nice little pickup I can give to my niece right there. This next one right here, I also got for 7 cents free shipping. It's Brooks Robinson. Hall of Fame third baseman, Robinson. This card here is from, like, I think a 1980 all-time great set. It's only worth, according to what, now I'm basing this on what I've seen other ones, because after I won this auction, I looked it up on eBay. A few other ones had actually been listed by other sellers for between a dollar and a half, buy it now process, and I got this for 7 cents free shipping. And the seller actually at one time, as you can see, had it for sale in his physical store for $1. Robinson, Hall of Famer, 16-time Gold Glove winner, very solid player for like 20-some years, played his whole career for Baltimore. And I got that from my buddy Tennessee, who I get a lot of my bargains from. He's always listing auctions at a penny starting bid, and I'm really pleased with that. This next lot is another Hall of Famer, Tony Gwynn. San Diego Padres, prestigious pros. This is from a 2005 Donruss set. It's an insert. And it's also short print numbered to 900, meaning only 900 of this card exist or were ever made. And I got that for 17 cent free shipping. Very, very pleased with that. A pickup of a Hall of Famer short print like that. Tony Gwynn, you know, won like 6-7 batting titles in his career. Awesome player. Awesome hitter, anyway. And when he was young, before he got kind of fat, he was actually a pretty good base dealer for a while. And, you know, I'll take that all day. If I can get a short print card like that of a Hall of Famer that cheap, I'll take it. This next lot is a four-card lot. I paid 56 cent free shipping for all four of these together. All four of these are short print cards. Only one of them is a Hall of Famer, but still, for 56 cent free shipping, the Hall of Famer in this lot was worth that much to me. And the fact the others are short printed as well, it's a nice pickup all the way around. The first one is Alex Gonzalez. These are all from 2005 Topps rookie debut set. Alex Gonzalez, it was a shortstop for the Florida Marlins. And on the back, this one is short print number to 199, as you can see down there at the bottom in gold. And that's the first one. The next one here is a Jerry Kuzman red border. Jerry Kuzman, most people remember him now as the other player on the Nolan Ryan rookie card. What they don't remember is Jerry Kuzman actually won over 200 games in his career, was a key part of the 1969 Miracle Mets baseball team. He was a big winner on that team, and was a big winner for the Mets for a lot of years. He also played on a lot of other teams and was a solid starter. This one is numbered to 399, as you can see there in the gold. All right, moving along. The next one here, T-Rex, as I called him. That was his nickname as a player. This one is a green border, and it is also number 199. And now the main one, Hall of Famer Paul Molitor. And this is a younger picture of him when he played with the Milwaukee Brewers. He played most of his career with Milwaukee. He played a few years near the end of his career for Toronto, and I think he played a year or so for Minnesota. This one is number 2499, and I'm very pleased with this lot, especially with that Molitor that I really like, because I like to pick up Hall of Famers cheap, especially short print. You get four short print cards for like 56 cent free shipping. You can't beat that. You can't beat it. So I'm very pleased with that. This next lot here. This right here is a pack of cards from what is known as the dead card era, but still it's unopened. I gave 20 cent free shipping for this. It's a 1990 pack of Score baseball cards. 20 cent free shipping, you can't beat. Hall of Famers, a lot of Hall of Famers from this set that you possibly could get a mint one out of here or two. There's also 1990 draft pick cards that were inserted from the 89 draft. By scoring the set, Frank Thomas rookie cards. Possibility to pull one of those out, and that'll be a good pack to let my nephew possibly bust open in a video in the future when I see him, or maybe put back with a few, till I get a few other packs and let him do a pack with bust video. At any rate, those cards will go to him. And if we pull a Frank Thomas Jim Min out of that thing, we'll send it off, get it graded, turn it in, go from a $8 card, maybe about a $40 or $50 card that way. If we got a PSA 10 out of it. Not expecting that, but, you know, crazier things have happened. At any rate, for 20 cent free shipping, I'm happy with that. So will my nephew be. This right here, this next one, is actually a relic. This is authentic, worn. And this is from Topps Allen and Jenner 2014 set. And this is her name is Laura Phelps. And I looked her up online after I won this because I really didn't know who she was. She is a world-famous bodybuilder. And she has competed for the United States in many events in the Olympics. And the patch right there, the little black patch, is actually an authentic worn by her. A sweatshirt material. It was where they took a shirt that she'd actually wore while she was training. And or working out, and they cut it up into pieces and inserted in these cards, and then put the cards into the Allen and Jenner set. And right here is the back of the cards. You can see it says Laura Phelps Sweat on the back. And I got this card, 37 cent free shipping, not bad for a relic. And actually, when I looked it up online, looked the lady up online to see who she was after I won it, because I just bid on it because it was an authentic relic of somebody that's supposed to be famous, a famous athlete. And she don't look anything like that picture. This is her, of course, when she was training. And this is actually a picture of, it's not really an authentic picture. It's more like a portrait. But she's actually it's funny because she's like a lot of women bodybuilders, or men for that matter. She's got the face of an actually attractive lady. But then her figure looks like, you know, some muscle-bound guy would look. But at any rate, game used relic, and being a female athlete, that's something that my niece, I think, will like also, to go with those women's basketball cards. And I'm happy with that pickup at that price, because most relics, even of people I've never heard of, I see selling for a couple of bucks online. This next one here is another Hall of Famer, but it's not a short print. It's Jerome Bettis. I thought for a second there I was saying it wrong. But anyway, Jerome Bettis. This is him with the Rams earlier in his career. And I'll show you the back of that card. It's a beautiful card, front and back. Bettis was drafted by the Rams. And he actually played his first few years in the NFL with the Rams. Most people don't remember that. What they do remember him for is the Rams traded him in a very bad trade for them to the Pittsburgh Steelers, where he turned into a Hall of Fame running back and played forever for the Steelers. And I got this card, by the way, for 12 cent free shipping. Very happy with that. Nice pickup of a Hall of Fame running back. It's in mint condition, by the way. And now this next one here, moving right along, is two different auctions I won from the same seller. And His name's Bobby. I buy a lot of cards from him at times on eBay. The first one is an on-card autograph. It is from the 2000 Royal Rookie Set, and that is an on-card autograph. And down there it is shoe. I don't know if you can see it, but it's serial numbered, short print numbered, 4,950. That means only 4,950 of these autographed inserts were placed in that particular set. I remember this set well. There was tons of autograph cards being placed in this set of all these different draft picks of that year. This one is of Christian Parker, who, by the way, best of my knowledge, never made it to the majors. Career minor leaguer, but still, it's an on-card auto, serial number, or short print. And cards like this will only go up in value. When I'm dead and gone and my nephew's my age 50 years from now, this will be like a common player from the 1950s Tops and Bowman sets right now that are selling for like $20 a piece on eBay in mint condition, especially being numbered only less than 5,000 made of this autograph insert. Years from now, collectors trying to put together all the autographs of this set pay a premium, you know, even though it's a guy that never really panned out as a prospect. The other card I got from Bobby, Hall of Famer John Elway. This is from 1992 Fleer. It's a portrait card. Beautiful card of John Elway, a Hall of Fame quarterback. I loved these cards when they came out with them, because this is back when I was originally still collecting, you know, and so was the Royal Rookies. Actually, I hadn't sold my original collection at that point when I got, you know, and I remember I bought and busted several boxes of these back in the day, trying to go for those autographs when they were a new issue. But the Elway I got for 10 cent free shipping. 17 cent free shipping, in case I didn't mention that a while ago. Very pleased with both those pickups. And, you know, that's all those together. You know, you can tell everything I've went over so far, I haven't even spent like about $3 total. If I've spent that much on everything I said, I don't think it's that much. And the last one is the one I spent the most on, and I still got it at a bargain. This is a 1976 Topps Dennis Eckersley rookie card. It's not in mint condition. It's not PSA graded, and it did come in this screw-down case. Found a seller who had this listed on eBay for $5 or best offer, free shipping. I put it on watch, and I messaged him and asked him some questions about it, because there is worries in today's world about cards being stored in these. And I'll be honest with you, I used to use these all the time back when I collected in my younger days, because back then that's all we had. There was no grading companies, and this is what they made to protect your most valuable cards. At any rate, my experience back then and my experience now is cards do not get damaged if you know what you're doing. There's no reason to over-tighten these things and smash your card or cause gum wax or you know, pack wax or whatever. From back in the old days, they used to seal packs of cards with wax, brand new, and they put bubble gum in them. There's also people handling them, gets body oil from their fingertips on the cards. And if you leave one completely sealed tight as you can get it for 20, 30 years, the card has been, known cards have, to seize to the plexiglass, or to some of these cases used to be made out of real glass. And then when you take it apart, the card would rip because it was stuck to each side. Well, main thing to do here, you can put these card in plastic sleeve and put it in here, but you can also, the main thing that I've found that seems to work for me, don't over tighten them. Turn your screws till they're snug and then stop. There's no reason to take that screwdriver and turn it another two or three cranks trying to really tighten it, because you do that to all four of you, that's when you're going to have problems. And also, PSA graders, do notice this. You send in a card that's been in one of these for 30 years and you've had it that tight, it's smashed. And when you take it out, to your eye, it doesn't appear that way, but when you send it in to be graded, even if it's not seized to the plexiglass or anything, PSA measure everything, they check everything, and they can tell. These grading companies that really do a good job, they can tell the card's been smashed, and they knock it down and grade. Now, back to this card. Eckersley is a Hall of Famer. He was a 20-game winner at one time for the Boston Red Sox. He was moved to the bullpen by Tony La Russa in the late 80s when Oakland traded for him, because La Russa noticed that Eckersley still had dominating stuff early in his starts, but it was later he seemed to tire after three or four innings and not be as effective. LaRussa moved into the bullpen where he only was asked to pitch one or two innings tops. He turned into the best closer in baseball for about a five-year stretch. He was an MVP winner. He was a Cy Young Award winner. And like I said, he also won over 100 games in his career as a starter before he became a closer. Truly a great pitcher. I loved to watch this guy pitch when I was a kid. Had a great windup, some very nasty stuff. Very good control pitcher. But this card, it does have a print mark at the, underneath the D on the bottom. That's a manufacturer's error, just a print mark. Things like that happen. It does knock down the value of a grade, though. It's also got some wear on the corners on all four, and it's off-center. As you can tell, the border top to bottom, the bottom border is wider than the top, and left to right is off-center as well. Same thing on the back. Anyway, back to the price. The seller was asking $5 or best offer for this card because it's not graded and because he knew it was not in great shape. And I offered him $3 for it. I expected him to come back with an offer, a counteroffer of $4. He took the $3, and it cost him $2.32 to ship this to me, so he didn't make much on a Hall of Fame rookie card. Now, if this card was in mint condition, it books for $30-$35 bucks. And if it was graded, I've seen on eBay PSA 8s and 9s selling for $30-$35 bucks, and I've seen PSA 10s going as high as $70-$80 bucks for this card. If I sent this card in to be graded to PSA, I would say at best, because of what all I just now told you is wrong. Also, by the way, those scratches at the top is not on the card. That's on this plexiglass holder. But if I sent this in to be graded, I would say I would not expect more than, at best, PSA 3. On a lucky day, a 4. More than likely, a 2 or 3. And I say that simply because, it would be better than a 2. It would probably be a 3 or 4. But I'm very particular about my cards usually, but a rookie card of a Hall of Famer I'll take. In my younger days when I had collected, before I sold all my collection when I was in my late 20s, and, you know, I just got recently started back because of my nephew collecting. But I had about three, I know I had three of these, I might have had four, that were in better shape than this one. And all of them, back in those days, I had in these type of holders. And anyway, they were all sold when I sold my original collection. But back then, this card was only worth about $8, you know. And I put them actually in screw downs, I remember, because of the fact I actually just had them in a regular 5,000 count box with a lot of the cards. And when Eckersley won the MVP and Cy Young, I pulled them out and put them in screw downs back then. Because like I said, this was the main thing to protect your cards. Because back then, after he won the MVP and Cy Young award in 92, that was when his cards started to take off. People started to talk about him as a possible Hall of Famer. At any rate, I'm very happy to get this card for $3. Free shipping. The holder alone, if you buy them on eBay, they're about anywhere from $1.50 to $2.50 per screw down holder. So, you know, I actually bought this card for the price of the holder, pretty much. And I'm happy with it because, you know, it is a Hall of Famer. This card, to tell you how old it really is or how old I really am, this card is 1 year younger than me because I was born in 75 and this is a 1976 Topps. At any rate, that's all for this eBay Breaks video. As you can see, all these bloggers together probably didn't cost me about $5. I'm very happy with them. And that's the kind of bargains I'm looking for. And you can find bargains like that too on eBay. And, you know, all you got to do is get out there and look and just check in every day. Spend 15 minutes just skimming through to see, you know, what's out there. I search for free shipping only. That's why everything I got here was free shipping. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, check out some of my others. I got a lot on my channel. Thanks for all my subscribers, and thanks for all my viewers especially. I'm getting a lot of viewers now coming from a lot of other guys that I'm friends with that do sports car breaks, and also from some of my Facebook groups. I mean, you know, has to do with sports cars. Like, share, and subscribe. If you got other friends you think would like my videos, share them to your Facebook so your friends can watch them. Again, thanks for watching. We'll be back again with you soon with another eBay Breaks.